papangurui. Tahoranui.
What are you doing?
Gardening. So we don't have to sleep on those. They're really bad.
They look really evil.
They are.
So we don't want them to pierce our tent, so we just like dislocate them. We are here in New Zealand, somewhere in the wilderness. Not really. It's just a camp spot, but it's a small one. So it just runs on donations, and they don't have like any drinking water. But what they do have is a river. So it solves our problem. That we have enough water for cooking, drinking, and washing our dishes. So I'm just heading down to the river and filter some water. Liters of water should be enough for cooking, washing our faces, and drinking for tomorrow. So I'm gonna head back up to the campground, back to Xenia, and she probably already started to cook. So what's for dinner?
Pasta with tomato sauce and olives and basil.
Sounds good.
Kita wipa
Beneath the outdoor light, it's just another graceless night. I hate the headlines and the weather. I'm 19 and I'm on fire, but when we're dancing, I'm alright. It's just another graceless night. Are you lost enough? Have another drink, get lost in us. This is how we get notorious. Oh, cause I don't know if they keep telling me where to go. I'll blow my brains out to the radio.
Time and trip around New Zealand. We are now back in Auckland, and we're really glad we can stay with Rick, with our friend again. He really has the right equipment and tools so we can clean our motorcycles really, really well. They have to be spotless when we want to get into New Zealand, into Australia. Like, we heard stories that you have to pay like $400 for extra cleaning if they just find like a little bit of sand or dirt or something. So I stripped down the Tangaroa yesterday, not like as crazy as in India. So it looks like this right now. So quite clean, I guess, but there's still some stuff we can wash better. There are the bits and pieces. So yeah. That's what I'm doing, and Xenia is on the run to get all the paperwork done. Carne is stamped and so on. So it's just 3 more days and the motorcycles have to be crated and they get picked up here. So this is a lot of work, and I better get going.
Every night I live and die. Meet somebody, take them home. Let's kiss and then take off our clothes. It's just another graceless.
We spent 3 days cleaning the motorcycles now. We repainted some black rusty stuff on the motorcycle so it looks like new and polished up some plastic parts. So we hope the Aussie's gonna really like them, and they're not gonna fine us for any dirt or anything. So we really tried to make sure they're not gonna find anything on them. And yeah, as you can see, they look like new. We just went to the BMW dealer and got some spare crates. They usually just throw it away. Just if you get wood, make sure it gets like a label like this. So it means it's like certified wood. So you're allowed to take it or ship it into Australia. Motorcycles are now in the crates, and we strapped them down with the orange straps, tied them down to the crate. And that's it.
Yay!
Two motorcycles cleaned and crated. Bikes are gone, so they're now on their way to Sydney, and fingers crossed it's all gonna be well, and there's not gonna be any delay this time. We'll see.
We would like to say a big thank you to all our patrons.
Special thanks goes to Karina Strebel, Monique Sakasir and Andreas Wegmüller. Without you guys, we couldn't share our adventure the way we do.
If you would like to become a patron, then check out our Patreon page. You find the link below in the comment section.
Thanks for watching and see you next time.